See, ST is a very, very important step for sequential designs, and most of the chips that we fabricate will be sequential in nature. What STA generally checks is whether the arrival time is lesser than the required arrival time, and whether the signal is sufficient, stays for sufficient long time so that it can be captured by the sync flop. And that's it, to put in one word. And STA doesn't check for functionality. It just assumes that design is functionally correct. So just to differentiate it from the dynamic timing analysis, see, dynamic timing analysis is more accurate than static timing analysis, and the dynamic timing analysis is done at the SPICE level. And this doesn't assume that the design is functionally correct. So you have to specify the stimulus vectors. For example, let's say you are checking on a decoder. You have to input the vectors at which the time at which the vectors rise, at the time at which the vectors falls, and then DTA analyzes the time at which output rises or falls, and that's how it works. And it doesn't completely analyze the design, and it is very, very slow, but it is very accurate. So this is just a comparison between STA and DTA. STA is exhaustive in nature because it doesn't have any functionality with this. So it analyzes the entire design, and then it reports the violations, and that's it. And DTA, because it depends on the stimulus vectors or input vectors, it tests all functionally correct scenarios and it reports the violation. So STA takes less time and it is more efficient, whereas dynamic timing analysis is takes more time. And generally, if you have missed providing one input vector set, we can't guarantee the output on that particular input vector set, and it requires more resources than STA.